So how much do you know about GMO foods? Well, joining us live from New York City to tell us more are cattle and soybean farmer Christina Sutton and corn and soybean farmer Julie Kennedy. Thanks so much for joining us this morning.
Hey, thank you.
Thanks for having us.
Yeah.
Well, let me ask you this first. We hear a lot. It's a pretty big issue out here in Hawaii. We hear a lot from the GMO corporations and companies that are involved in all of this, but it's not as often that we hear directly from farmers talking about GMOs and supporting the benefits of that. Tell me, how did this all come about? Why are the two of you here and on something of a national tour, I guess?
Yeah, so Christina and I are part of a group called Common Ground, and it's a group of farm women who volunteer from across the country to connect with consumers. So we're fortunate enough to see what happens on our farms on a daily basis, but we really want to share that story with everyone else and other people who are interested in how their food is grown. So that's the organization that we're part of, and we've got a great website too, findourcommonground.com.
Okay, so let's talk about GMOs. A lot of people are familiar with it, but not everybody. What, explain to people in a nutshell as best you can, what are GMOs?
Yeah, so GMOs are, it stands for a genetically modified organism, and when you think about it, farmers and scientists have been improving plants for thousands of years, and when we use GMOs, we're really just taking that process into the lab. So we're speeding up the development where we can bring new and better products to market and to our farms. So some of the traits or the proteins that GMOs include are things like protection against certain diseases or insects, or really helping us manage weeds better on our farms.
You know, I think that a big question for a lot of people still to this day, are they safe? You know, we hear about the benefits, how they can help populations in need, but there's still a lot of concern that there's not enough research, not enough studies done to make sure these truly are safe for consumption.
Yeah, so I always reiterate to people that ask me about GMOs, are they safe? Well, absolutely they're safe. You know, the EPA, the USDA, the FDA, they've all worked together to do tons of research. You know, over $136 million go into the study of these products. And not only that, we're farmers. I'm in southeast Missouri, and I want to make sure that, as a farmer, I want to make sure that my crops that I'm growing is safe for human consumption. I don't want anybody to ever not be healthy because they've consumed our crops.
Last question for you guys. I'm sorry. Go ahead.
That's okay. So, you know, as Christina mentioned, we're farmers, but we're also moms.
Yeah.
And, you know, I think what she was talking about is the fact that we're growing these products on in our fields, but we're also feeding them to our families. So I'm completely confident in the technology and comfortable in the regulatory process and the testing that goes into them.
All right. Well, thank you so much, both of you, again, carrying on, spreading the message. FindOurCommonGround.com if folks want any more information. Thank you so much for joining us this morning.
Thank you.
Thank you.